السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. أنا علي الغزالي وأهلا وسهلا بكم في اللسان. Today إن شاء الله we delve into the 14th chapter. الوحدة الرابعة عشرة. Titled الأمن. الأمن, which means safety and security. The word الأمن comes from the verb أمين يأمن. أمين يأمن, which means to feel safe. أمين يأمن is to be safe and to be secure. And the opposite of أمين يأمن is خاف يخاف, which means to be scared, to fear. خاف يخاف. And I think we covered this verb before. And the مصدر of خاف يخاف is الخوف. الخوف. So الخوف is in a sense the opposite of الأمن. الأمن, safety and security. الخوف, fear. All right, let's get right into the first dialogue we have here. It's titled حادث سرقة. حادث سرقة. The word سرقة comes from the verb سرقة سرقة يسرق. Sorry, سرقة. The verb is سرقة يسرق, which means to steal or to rob. سرقة يسرق. And سرقة is the مصدر, is the theft itself. So حادث سرقة means a theft basically. حادث سرقة, an incident of theft. حادث سرقة. And the person who steals, the thief, is called in Arabic سارق. As Allah says in the Quran, والسارق والسارقة فاقطعوا أيديهما. And it's also called لص. So لص with a shadda on the side, and the jama is لصوص, means a thief. لص and لصوص. Alright, we have a dialogue here between فيصل and جعفر. يقول فيصل السلام عليكم. وعليكم السلام. هل شاهدت الأخبار في التلفاز أمس؟ الفعل شاهد يشاهد means to view or to see. So have you seen the أخبار, الأخبار, الأخبار جمع خبر. الخبر, the word خبر means news or like one piece of news. والأخبار is the جمع. Have you heard or have you watched the news في التلفاز, in the TV, أمس, yesterday. قال فيصل تقصد حادث سرقة المصرف الوطني. تقصد, he's meant to say هل تقصد, do you mean, this is a question, right? But sometimes we just remove هل, because you know a lot of the times it is very clear from our intonation that we are asking a question. تقصد حادث السرقة, do you mean the theft of المصرف الوطني, the national مصرف, the national bank. We said that مصرف is bank. وطني means national. Comes from the word وطن, which means country or a home country. المصرف الوطني. قال جعفر نعم لقد أخافني ذلك الحادث كثيرا. We said خاف يخاف means to be scared of something, right? To fear something. If I add a همزة to it, becomes أخاف يخيف, which means to scare someone, to make someone scared. أخاف يخيف. So he's saying لقد أخافني ذلك. That really scared me, frightened me. لقد أخافني ذلك الحادث كثيرا. لم تكن بلادنا تعرف هذا النوع من الجريمة. بلادنا, as in our country, did not know, didn't used to know, لم تكن تعرف, that kind of crime. هذا النوع من الجريمة من قبل, from before. لم تكن تعرف هذا النوع من الجريمة من قبل. قال فيصل لكنني شعرت بالاطمئنان. الفعل اطمأن يطمئن. اطمأن يطمئن. And the مصدر is اطمئنان, means to be reassured and to feel safe. As Allah says in the Quran, أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. It is through the remembrance of God that hearts find rest, if you can say. تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ, reassurance. لَكِنَّنِي شَعَرْتُ بِالْإِطْمَئِنَانِ, I felt relief, I felt reassurance. عِنْدَمَا قَبَضَتِ الشُّرْطَةُ عَلَى الْجُنَاتِ بَعْدَ سَاعَاتِ. الفعل قَبَضَ يَقْبِضُ. قَبَضَ يَقْبِضُ in this context means to arrest. قَبَضَ يَقْبِضُ means to arrest something. And قَبَضَ يَقْبِضُ, generally speaking, could also mean to hold something in your hands, in your fist, like to hold someone or something. Okay, so we can use it. I can say, for example, قَبَضْتُ عَلَى الْقَلَمِ. قَبَضْتُ عَلَى الْقَلَمِ, يعني I had it in my grip. قَبَضْتُ عَلَيْهِ. And we can also say قَبَضَ يَدَهُ, that means to close his hand like that. قَبَضَ يَدَهُ. قَبَضَ بمعنى to close hand. So قَبَضَتْ الشُّرْطَةُ عَلَى الْجُنَاءِ, يعني the police sort of arrested عَلَى الْجُنَاتِ. الْجُنَاء جَمْعُ جَانِي, وَالْجَانِي هُوَ الْمُجْرِمِ. الْجَانِي equals مجرم, criminal. والجناة المجرمون, the criminals. Okay, so it's as if the police had its hand grabbing and closing on the criminals. قبضت الشرطة على الجناة بعد ساعات, after a few hours. قال جعفر لقد زادت الجريمة عندنا أخيرا. Crime has increased. عندنا, عندنا يعني in our country. عندنا أخيرا, recently. أخيرا. قال فيصل لكنها ما زالت قليلة مقارنة بالدول الأخرى. ما زالت قليلة, ما زال together, ما زال means remained or still. Okay, I can say ما زال زيد في البيت, that means زيد is still at home. Okay, ما زال عمر مريضا, he's still sick, and so on. لكنها ما زالت, but it is still قليلة, still, you know, little, or the crime rate is still low. مقارنة بالدول الأخرى, comparing to other countries. So مقارنة هو مصدر قارن يقارن, which means to compare. قارن يقارن means to compare. مقارنة بالدول الأخرى. And قارن يقارن essentially comes from the verb قارن يقرن, which means to put two things together. تقول قارنت زيدا بعمر, يعني I put them together, I tie them together. Okay, and that's why the Arabs call a close friend, someone who's always with you, spends a lot of time with you, the Arabs call him قرين. So قرين means a close friend. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in the Quran that every human being has a qareen, as in a jinn, that is always with him. And that's why it's called qareen, because it's tied to you. It comes from the verb qarana yaqreenu, which means to tie two things together. So qarana yuqarin with alif, to compare. And in comparison, you almost like put two things together as well. And qarana yaqreenu, it means to tie two things together. قال جعفر أتفق معك. أتفق معك, I agree with you. فقد قضيت العطلة الماضية, I spent the last holiday في إحدى الدول الكبرى. إحدى means one of, and أحد means one of as well. أحد الطلاب, one of the students. إحدى الطلاب, one of the students. But أحد is masculine and إحدى is feminine. إحدى is feminine. إحدى الطلاب يعني one girl, one female from the students. أو أحد الطلاب يعني one male. في إحدى الدول الكبرى. And since the word دول is the جمع of دولة, which is a feminine word, he said إحدى الدول الكبرى. لم نكن نخرج من الفندق بعد غروب الشمس. يعني we didn't leave the hotel after sunset because it wasn't safe. بعد غروب الشمس خوفا out of fear من حوادث السرقة والقتل. خوفا من out of fear of the accidents or the incidents of theft and murder. حوادث السرقة والقتل ماذا؟ قال فيصل بل تقع الجريمة أحيانا في تلك البلاد في النهار. أحيانا sometimes تقع الجريمة crime occurs. We covered the verb وقع يقع previously. بل تقع الجريمة أحيانا في تلك البلاد in those countries في النهار in daylight in daytime في النهار. قال جعفر أخاف أن تنتقل العدوى إلى بلادنا. The word عدوى means we can say infection. Okay. So he's saying I fear أخاف أن تنتقل العدوى إلى بلادنا. I fear that the infection, which is being used metaphorically, referring to the crime, the high crime rate. He's afraid that this infection or this disease would, you know, would move to our country. أن ينتقل تنتقل العدوى إلى بلادنا فتنتشر جرائم القتل والاغتصاب. And if that happens, the crimes of قتل مادة والاغتصاب would spread. فتنتشر جرائم القتل والاغتصاب. الاغتصاب هو مصدر اغتصب يغتصب. اغتصب يغتصب. Which literally means to take something forcefully. To take something without any right using force. That's اغتصب يغتصب. اغتصب يغتصب. And it could also mean to rape a woman or, you know, to rape generally. اغتصب يغتصب. قال فيصل أسأل الله ألا يحدث ذلك. I ask Allah that this doesn't happen. ألا here was essentially أن لا. But when you pronounce them together, they sound like ألا. And they also would be written ألا. أسأل الله, I ask Allah that this doesn't happen. أن لا يحدث ذلك. قال جعفر أحسنت. فالحياة لا تساوي شيئا. Life doesn't equal anything. بلا أمن. Without safety. فالحياة لا تساوي شيئا. بلا أمن. The verb ساوى يساوي means to be equal. It doesn't equal anything without safety. قال فيصل أدام الله علينا نعمة الأمن. آمين. The verb أدام يديم comes essentially from دام يدوم. دام يدوم means to be lasting for a long time or lasting forever. دام يدوم. And this verb is لازم, so it doesn't require an object. دام يدوم. If I add a همزة to it, it becomes متعدي. So I say دام أدام, sorry, أدام يديم, which means to make something last long. To make something last long. أدام الله علينا نعمة الأمن. That means may Allah make that blessing of safety last long. أدام الله علينا نعمة الأمن. قال جعفر آمين آمين. I hope I clarified this dialogue. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave them in the comment section below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And I will be speaking to you very soon. Assalamu alaikum.